Hello, I am Professor Tejas Patel, working as Assistant Professor at Kalol Institute of Technology and Research Center. Today we will discuss about some topics which are related to the vibration. Now we will go some basics of vibration. Vibration. We will discuss some terminology which are related to that. So first is periodic motion, it is a motion which is itself at equal interval of time. Also we will discuss about the time period. So time period is, these are the basic terms which are, you have to study all these terms while you are going to analyze any vibratory body. So time taken to complete one cycle, is called the time period. Next is amplitude. The maximum displacement of a vibrating body is called amplitude. The basic main terms are amplitude, frequency, and frequency is number of cycle per unit time, number of cycles per unit time. So while we are discussing about the frequency, we can also discuss, there is a, in vibration there is a types of frequencies are natural frequency, so natural frequency is defined as, we are knowing that the vibration can be classified as a free vibration or a forced vibration. In a free vibration, only one time external excitation force is applied to the body, after that it oscillates itself. That type of frequency of a vibratory body is called the natural frequency. It means external excitation force is applied for the one time only, so it is called the natural frequency. After that we will discuss about degree of freedom for the vibratory body. So degree of freedom can be classified as, we have studied in kinematics of machinery, same way we can classify that, same way we can identify that. So degree of freedom is a minimum number of independent variable required to describe the motion of any component is called the degree of freedom. So these all are the basic parameters which we are studying. These are the basic terminology required to describe the motion of any component or vibration of any component. For analysis of any vibratory body, there are three methods are used. So one is energy method, second one is Rayleigh's method, third one is equilibrium method, and fourth one is also Newton's method. So out of these four methods, today we will discuss about one method, that is a energy method. So as we are knowing that law of energy indicates that energy neither be created nor it can be destroyed. So according to that, energy associated with the system is constant. So for describing this method, I will consider one spring mass system. Here is a spring which is having a stiffness of K, and with that there is a mass M attached with that. So Here is the hinge point. So from there, spring is attached with the mass m, which is having a magnitude of m. So as mentioned in the figure, here is x displacement is given to the body. So x is a displacement which is given to the body, and when x displacement is given to the body, it will have a motion like this, to and fro, reciprocating motion. It will have a movement up and down in this direction. So according to this energy method, this system is having oscillating this system is having some to and fro motion. So that motion is due to some external excitation force F, which is one time given. After that, F initial is not equal to zero, and after that F is equal to zero. Some external excitation force M is given to the body. After that, it oscillates itself because there is no force applied, because it is a free vibration. We are discussing about the free vibration, and system which we have considered is a single degree of freedom. So here is a K, which is the stiffness of a spring, M is a mass, X is a displacement, and F initial is given, which is not equal to zero. Some magnitude is given. After that, this body will oscillate. So according to the energy method, when the body is into the motion, there is a two types of energies are available in that. One is kinetic energy and second one is potential energy. According to that, kinetic energy, which is having due to the motion, and potential energy, which is a stored energy. So according to the energy conservation law, it indicates that the total energy is equal to constant. So the energy which is related to this system is a total kinetic energy plus total potential energy. So total kinetic energy plus total potential energy equal to zero. So kinetic energy is due to this mass m, because F initial is given to the mass m, and after that it oscillates. So it can be given as we are knowing, the kinetic energy of inline motion is given by 1/2 mv square, which can be given as 1/2 mv square, where m is equal to the mass, v is equal to the velocity. In terms of vibration, v is indicated here. X is a displacement, and change in displacement in unidirection is so that dx upon dt is called the x dot is equal to the v, and double derivation of the displacement x double dot is equal to the a, which is a acceleration, and here x dot v is equal to the velocity. So in place of v, we have kept here x dot, and here the potential energy can be given 1/2 kx square according to the strain energy law, because when the force is applied at here, this spring is stretched in, stretched out, and after that, when mass goes in upward direction, this spring is stretched in. So according to that, the potential energy is a stored energy which is at here, and it is a strain energy. So it is 1/2 kx square. Now here total energy we have found it out. So to kinetic energy is energy of mass m, and 1/2 kx square is a potential energy. Now here is a constant. Now from here we can know that 1/2 mx dot square plus 1/2 kx square is equal to constant. Now we will derivate the whole system with respect to the time, because it is a variable, it is a derivation of time, because here is the x dot, that is the velocity, and here is the x, which is a displacement. Now when we derivate the equation with respect to the time, it can be given as 1/2 is as it is, m is as it is, it is a constant. So derivation of x dot square is given by 2 into x dot into x double dot, okay, plus same way 1/2 k as it is 2 x into x dot equal to, and the derivation of constant is 0. So from here, when we simplify the term, 2 and 2 is cancelled out, here is 2 and 2 is cancelled out, so remaining is mx dot and x double dot plus kx x dot equal to 0. So here the common is x dot and x dot, so we will remove it, so remaining is mx double dot plus kx equal to 0, which is called the characteristics equation of given system. So same, by using the same methodology, we can find out the characteristics equation for all the systems. Now we will go, I will explain with respect to the velocity. If we are considering that the motion is here is to and fro motion, so according to that it may be the simple harmonic motion. So according to the simple harmonic motion equation, the displacement can be given as x equal to a sine omega t. When we derivate this equation with respect to the time, then the velocity will be given, so x dot is equal to a omega. Derivation of sine omega t is a cos omega t, and omega is also extra, so it is at here. So same way we will derivate the x dot, so we will get the x double dot, because we required x double dot to keep it here. So x double dot equal to a omega square sine omega t. Now we will keep all these values of x double dot and x at here, so we will get x double dot is given by, here is a minus a omega square sine omega t, and m is at here, plus k a sine omega t equal to 0. Now we simplify the term, so sine omega t is common, so it can be neglected, so the remaining is m a omega square plus k a equal to 0. Here a is also common, so remaining is, here is a minus m omega square plus k equal to 0. When we simplify the term, so it will be m omega square equal to k, so omega square equal to k by m, and omega is equal to under root of k by m, and it is a natural frequency of a vibrating body, which is shown in a figure. Now I will explain one example which has been many times there should be in university examination, that find out the natural frequency of a vibratory body, which is shown in a figure. So I have shown here one pulley. Write a equation of motion of a system as shown in figure, find the natural frequency. So as shown in a figure, here is a one pulley given. That pulley is wounded with one string, and one end of that string is fixed, and with that fixed end there is a spring attached, and at the another end of that string there is one mass m is attached, and the mass of that pulley is m, radius of pulley is r given, and x displacement is given to this mass m. Okay, so now we have to solve this problem. So before we are going to discuss about the solution of problem, what we will study, we will identify that which method we will apply. As I have told you previously, that there is four methods: energy method, Raylet's method, equilibrium method, and Newton's method. Out of them, we have studied today energy method, so I will apply it. So you can apply any of these four methods, but right now we are applying the energy method. So according to that method, here is the x displacement is given to the body. As we are knowing, according to the energy method, we are dealing with the energies which are associated with the energies of kinetic as well as the potential energy. Now we will go here, x displacement is given to the mass m, and here is a spring which is having a stiffness of k. So when x displacement is given to the mass m, this mass will be displaced at here mass m is displaced, so this displacement is x. When this displacement is x, so this spring will be stretched out x displacement, because here is a whole string. When x displacement is given to the mass m, this pulley will rotate. When pulley will rotate, the string, this spring will be stretched out. So whatever should be the displacement of mass should be the displacement of spring. So if here is x displacement, same displacement is given to the spring, and pulley is having a rotation. So when x displacement is at here, so here is the theta displacement of a pulley, here is a theta displacement of pulley. Okay, so if here is a theta displacement of pulley, so here is a rotary displacement, here is a linear displacement. So we will compare all these values, as we are knowing x equal to r theta, because here is a nominal term of cos theta. When we resolve the forces, this displacement will be r cos theta. So theta is very small value, so cos 0 r equal to, sorry, x equal to r cos theta. So theta is very small, theta is small, so we can write x equal to r cos 0. So cos 0 is equal to, sorry, cos theta, so it can be written as very small value x equal to r theta, x equal to r theta. Okay, so we have found out the relation between the linear displacement as well as the rotational displacement. So x equal to r theta, where x is a linear displacement and theta is a angular displacement. Now for the whole system, we have to find out the natural frequency of the system. So to calculate that, we have to calculate the total energy of the system. So total energy is total kinetic energy of the system and total potential energy of the system. So here is two masses are there. One is a mass of pulley is available, M, capital M, and some mass M is attached at the end of the string. So the potential energy, total kinetic energy, can be given as 1/2 of mx dot square plus 1/2 mx dot square, as well as here some angular moment is there, so we will also consider the polar mass moment of inertia. So it can be 1/2 kinetic energy of the pulley is given by 1/2 j theta dot square, and kinetic energy of the mass is given by 1/2 mx dot plus 1/2 capital mx dot square. So now total energy is summation of these two parts, so this one is written as here and this one is that here. Now we will go to the potential energy. So potential energy is the restoring energy which is given, which is available at here. So restoring energy is 1/2 kx square, which is the strain energy of the spring. So total energy is equal to total kinetic energy plus total potential energy, and energy conservation rule indicates that total energy equal to constant. So from here we will do the submission of all these parts. So it is 1/2 kx square plus 1/2 mx dot square plus 1/2 j theta dot square plus 1/2 mx dot square equal to constant. Now we will keep these terms which are x dot square separately. So 1/2 m plus m x dot square plus 1/2 j theta dot square plus 1/2 k x square equal to constant. And as you can see in this equation, here the displacements are there, the variable is a displacement. So displacements are in two terms, one is a linear displacement, another one is angular displacement. So betterment of calculation, we will convert any of the term. So for that, here is a only angular displacement, so we are converting that angular displacement in the linear displacement. So it can be written as here we can write derivation of all the parts, and we have also derivated the equation. So when you derivate the equation, it will be 1/2 1/2 cancel out, as shown at here. The derivated part is here, so 1 m plus m x dot 2 and 2 are cancel out, So remaining is x dot plus x, x dot into x double dot, same weight here and here. When you apply the equation here, the same as I have told that the displacement is in angular as well as linear, so we are converting in one part. So as here x equal to r theta, we have mentioned x equal to r theta, so x dot equal to r theta dot and x double dot equal to r theta double dot. So from there, here we required is x theta dot and theta double dot. So keep the values from here, theta dot equal to x dot upon r and theta double dot equal to x double dot upon r. Now keep the value, so we will get m plus m x dot into x double dot plus j upon r square x dot into x double dot plus kx into x dot equal to 0. Now we simplify the term, so it is m plus j upon r square into x double dot plus kx equal to 0. We have separated the terms which are related to x double dot, so we have combined this one plus this one. Now this equation is as we have derived the equation previously, which is mx double dot plus kx equal to 0, and according to that equation the frequency omega n can be written as under root of k upon m. So k is at here and the m is at here. So now we will compare the values. So omega n is equal to under root of k upon m plus j upon r square by comparing with the equation, this one with the value of this one. So its unit is radian per second or hertz. So this one is the energy method that we have discussed today. If you have any doubt related to the energy method, kindly contact. I will explain you in brief. Thank you.